Hi friends, welcome back to my channel and welcome if you're new here. My name is Jen, I'm a certified weight loss and nutrition coach and I'm on the WW or the Weight Watchers Blue Plan. Happy Friday. It's Friday, so it's weigh-in day. I'm going to share with you guys how my week was. We'll set some goals moving into next week. We'll talk about the WW workshop. Of course, I'll be sharing this week's weigh-in. So if you're excited and you are here for another Friday weigh-in, give this video a big, huge thumbs up. And if you're new or you haven't yet subscribed, I would love to have you here. Hit the subscribe button and click the bell right next to it so you never miss a single video. Like I said, we do this Friday weigh-in thing every single week. Check out the description box down below for my two recipe ebooks. I've released breakfast and lunch. Both contain 15 recipes. WW plan points for all three plans included, as well as calories. I will be releasing the dinner ebook very shortly, so make sure you pick these two up so you'll have the full collection once all four ebooks are released. You'll also find nutrition coaching, where I offer personalized to you macros and calories. Highly recommend, so you know exactly where you should be every day to lose weight. Also offer one-on-one coaching if you would like to chat with me directly. I'd love to talk with you. Links, discounts to all my favorite things and my Facebook group. Head on over, join us there. We would love to have you over there as well. So let's jump into this Friday weigh-in workshop topic and I'll let you guys know how my week was. Hope you had an absolutely fantastic week as we move into the second week of October. I can't believe it is already the second week of October, my favorite time of year. I am in the Halloween spirit. You can see that I have Halloween decorations behind me. I did put some cute little LED lights up in my background. And of course, I had to change them to orange because 'tis the season, right? I am loving this feeling of fall as we move into Halloween and Thanksgiving and Christmas. It's absolutely my favorite time of the year. This last week was really, really good. I came back from my trip. I got right back on track. I've been doing really well with eating and tracking. I'm feeling really good about where I am on my weight loss journey. As I mentioned in last week's weigh-in, I'm going to continue to try to see the scale go down in the month of October and then reassess as we move into the last couple months of the year. But I am in weight loss mode and I'm doing really well when it comes to food and tracking. I'm also going to jazzercise 2 to 3 times a week, which is my goal every single week. This last Saturday, I spent the entire day deep cleaning my house, so I didn't go to jazzercise just because I spent the day cleaning. But this week, I actually am going Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. So I'm going to get in all 3 days, which is really good. It's so good for me. I always feel so good after I finish my workout. I'm gearing myself up for another really good week. But before I share with you this week's weigh-in, let's talk a little bit about this week's WW workshop topic. Also in Wednesday's What I Eat in a Day, I did share the information that I've received when it comes to the new WW programs coming out in November of this year. So if you haven't seen that video, head on over there, check it out so that you can get all of the updates. But this week's workshop topic is about getting to know your eating patterns. This is really important. We need to know what triggers us to overeat, what triggers us to be hungry, what triggers us to choose certain foods. It's really important to be in tune with your specific eating pattern. So try this. Pick 3 days this next week and take notes on how and what you're eating. And of course, how that food impacts you. So some tips on how to do this is right before you consume your meal, sit down and jot this down. Spend blank hours or minutes since I last ate. My hunger level is a blank. One would be that you're full and satisfied, up to 5, which is that you're ravenously hungry or you're starving. Next, ask yourself, I feel blank. Examples would be energized, proud, bummed out, regretful, exhausted. Your choice of how you're feeling in the moment. Number 2 is to track your meal or snack, whatever it is that you choose to have. And number 3 is after you've consumed your meal or snack, wait 30 minutes. Using that same journal, document exactly how you feel going back to step 1. Fill in the blank below. The amount I ate was. Was it what you planned, less than you planned, or more than you planned? Also reassess your hunger level. Where are you now? Are you a 1 where you're full and satisfied, or are you still a 5 where you're ravenously hungry, or are you falling somewhere in the middle? And then ask yourself, the speed at which I ate was 1 slow all the way up to 5, which is rather quickly. And then gauge your mindfulness. My mindfulness was a 1 not mindful all the way up to 5, which is majorly mindful. Or again, did you fall somewhere in the middle? Then you're gonna wanna ask yourself, it's blank that I'll eat something before my next planned meal or snack. That could be unlikely, likely, or not sure. And then ask yourself, the foods I enjoyed most in my meal were, and list those out. What were your favorite foods of that meal or snack that you had? And then ask yourself how you feel. Now, how do you feel after your snack? Are you energized? Are you bummed out? Do you feel really good? Are you full? Are you happy? And just repeat this every time you eat throughout the day. I really, 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 really like this. It leads you to recognize your hunger signals, how those hunger signals are for you, what you choose to do when you feel those hunger signals, and how you feel after you consume a meal. Are you someone that doesn't gauge at all your feelings of fullness or hunger? Are you someone that never wants to feel hunger pangs and make sure that you're consuming food throughout the day, whether you're hungry or not, so that you don't have to feel hungry? It's really important to stay in tune with our bodies. It's really important to learn our eating habits. I really like this topic because it lends itself to intuitive eating. It lends itself to learning your hunger signals, learning your body, only eating when you're hungry, not because you have leftover points or calories for the day, but only when you're truly, truly hungry. Learn your eating patterns and then work on those eating patterns to make them fit your lifestyle and to benefit you in whatever weight loss or weight maintenance goal that you're in. It looks like this is going to be the series of the next few weeks of WW topics about eating patterns. And I'm here for it. I think this is extremely, extremely important for long-term success when you're continuing to lose weight or even at maintenance. So now let's jump into how my weight was when I stepped on the scale. Like I said, I had a good week. I'm really proud of myself for tracking and choosing good foods. When I stepped on the scale, I am down 1.2 pounds. So I lost that 0.6 that I gained last week after my vacation, plus quite a bit more, which makes me really happy. I feel like when I stepped on the scale this week, my hard work actually paid off and showed up on the scale. We know that doesn't always happen, but I'm so happy to be moving into the next week of October with a loss of 1.2 pounds. That means that I have lost 69 pounds so far, which is absolutely incredible. 1 pound away from 70 pounds completely blows my mind. Now, I still have a lot to lose and I'm getting there slowly, but I feel really good about my progress. No matter how long it takes me, I'm keeping it off and I'm continually seeing that scale go down, and I'm eating more than I've ever eaten before. So I truly am eating more to lose weight. So moving into next week, I'm going to continue to track my food, make good food choices, and I'm really going to listen to my body. I've made that something that I've been focused on over the last few months, really just intuitively listening to my body, but I'm going to really amp that up and do that a little bit more and not worry about having leftover points or calories at the end of the day, because if I'm not hungry, I shouldn't be eating. And that's really the reality. I know it's important to eat enough calories and points throughout the day. So if you find yourself at the end of the day with lots of calories or points left over, just try to have bigger meals throughout the day. Add in some healthy fats or things that cost more calories or points, like nut butter or avocado, to get to your calorie or points goal, but also not to eat if you're not truly hungry. So I'm really excited to implement this into this next week. So now I want to hear from you guys. How was your week? Did you gain? Did you lose? How do you feel about this whole really being mindful and thinking about your hunger signals and just really being in tune with your body when it comes to choosing your meals and snacks? So definitely let me know down in the comments. Just a reminder to check out Wednesday's What I Eat in a Day if you want the 411 on what's happening with WW, or at least allegedly what's happening with WW in the month of November. As always, I will be putting out a video the minute the information is released, giving you my honest opinion. So that video will go out as soon as the concrete plan information is released. So if you enjoyed today's video, don't forget to give it a big thumbs up. And if you're new or you haven't yet subscribed, I would love to have you here. Hit the subscribe button and don't forget to click the bell right next to it so you never miss a single video. Like I said, we do this weigh-in thing every single Friday. Check out the description box down below for the two recipe ebooks, nutrition coaching, links, discounts to all my favorite things. And don't forget to head over and join us on Facebook. You can keep up with me a little bit easier there, and we'd love to have you join that community. Thank you again for watching, and I'll see you in tomorrow's grocery haul.